purpose of this video briefly is a slight change in the lineup. Here are some clear ink chamber pens. Start with the Charlie. Many of you are familiar with it, included with 4.5 ounce bottles free of charge. Any cost associated with a 4.5 ounce bottle that has one of these is the ink, the bottle, the pipette, the dropper, the box, and the transportation. This is never included in the cost. It's always freely given out. That's why it's not for sale. Then the nib creeper, flex nib, ebonite feed, piston filling. All of these are made out of cotton butyrate. It's very, very durable, as I'll explain later in this video and have explained in other videos. And this is the nibbed version of the clear Konrad. Can be disassembled. Even the filler unit, there's a pin just like in the 1930s versions. The pin enabled you to disassemble the entire filler unit. This unscrews just with a firm grip or a little bit of rubber, but always put it on tight enough that you never have a situation where the cover, the end cap, comes off with the filler. You want that tight in the barrel, so this always comes off, even if you have to squeeze it a bit, so that this never falls off in your pocket or on the ground. The Ahab. I always dreamed of an extremely efficient flushing filler. Basically, it's two pumps. Fills the whole thing. Uses the breather tube to pump out all the air. It's extremely efficient. And also uses the smallest Noodler's ink bottle. You can use a 308 cartridge with this. Likewise, you can use the 308 cartridge with a triple tail, and it has that same filler. Two movements, flushes it right out, fills it up, gets rid of the air, replaces it with ink. And uniquely, a three-tined nib, which I always liked as a kid. I was very fond of music nibs. This used to be ebonite. It was replaced with this feed, which when you put black in it, it looks like a bumblebee back. It sort of stripes. It looks neat. And I like it in particular because there are those people who want that rollerball style flow, and they're used to rollerballs, but biodegradable, tough as can be, and very affordable to replace that tip if it were to ever wear out. And it takes a very long time to wear out that tip. It's very durable. Then we have this one, which is the newest. And this is because they ran out of Konrad brush pens in the UK. That's my understanding of it. And they needed some more brush pens, Konrad brush pens, for inventory. So this was made similar to the Ahab brush pen, which might be out of stock, but that's going to change. I'm working on it. And it's not yet in the States, mainly because the States, we didn't run out of the handmade ebonite one yet. But I think there are only like 100 of them left. It has a thinner brush, and this was a handcrafted ebonite feed, and the economics didn't work. It came in a few models. It hasn't been made for quite a while, and the very last few are available at a handful of retailers. And once they're gone, it's a collectible. It's not coming back. This is its replacement. And the following video explains a little bit more about this and how it relates to this roller, the sink ball. I hope you enjoy the little demonstration I have for you. I think this is a type of government paper, Commonwealth of Massachusetts. This is a bottle of Noodler's Black that I've used and refilled for a few years, since the label change anyway. This is a bottle. It was a young lady at the New England Pen Show, Commonwealth Pen Show, a few years ago, and she wanted a bottle of Noodler's Black. She had run out of money at the end of the day, and she had this bottle of Parker Quink Black. I think it's a modern bottle. It is made in France, but it's a competitor's product, and I figured I'd use it to do a little demonstration. I gave her the bottle of Noodler's Black. She had run out of money, and I figured it was a new customer, and maybe she'd try a Noodler's product, and maybe she'd be corrupted for life and use Noodler's instead. So I traded this bottle of Quink. Let's see, there's a nice swatch of it. And I gave her a full bottle of Noodler's Black. Okay. PQ and NB. Let that dry a little bit. some of my first customers wanted Noodler's Black to not feather on newsprint. And also not to come out of it in the rain for use in crossword puzzles. Although I think it was the New York Times, and I don't think the Wall Street Journal has a crossword. This is a local paper. I like to call it the Substandard Times. The only thing good about it is that it has a sperm whale on the front. But it is a slightly different grade of newsprint. And what I'm going to do cut it a little off. Okay, this is the PQ, and you'll see why I'm writing its identifier not in this stuff. Now that's household bleach. Just making sure these are completely dry. You see the color change in the paper. I don't know if they're still using the old-fashioned kind of inks. Now, if that sits there for too long, it will eat the paper. Now, the purpose of this video, I wanted to point out, in the UK, recently. These new Konrad clear brush pens were issued. They're not in the United States yet. I wanted to point out to those customers who are in the UK that this particular pen interchanges with the Konrad ink ball. Now, they're not identical pens. Their inner cap is a little different. However, you can interchange the brush for the roller. Like that. I'm going to have to get tweezers for that, because if you get that on your fingers, it's not pleasant. Now, if any of you worry about the air ball in these, when you have a large air bubble in this, I tend to like to reduce the air bubble. And this pen's towards the end of its filling. I've reduced the air all the way up here. And I will refill those now and then show you the results of this, which is almost done. It's a few more seconds. Now, I just want to note that this particular pen's only been filled with Noodler's Black its entire useful life. And repeatedly, the air bubble is always pushed out. It's just my habit with these. I don't like the potential of a thunderstorm coming overhead and an air bubble expanding with the heat of my hand. It's sort of like a Charlie pen. I tend to refill the Charlie pen as soon as the air bubble gets too big. I don't like it expanding. Just fountain pen etiquette, I guess. But you'll note that that is a clear barrel. It pushes the Noodler's Black off the plastic just through the action of the seal in the piston every time you push it forward, and it's clear. You see, it's a little bit of gray. This feed disassembles from the front, and you can rinse that out under the tap if that little bit of gray bugs you. And a little bit of material on the silicone grease that seals the O-ring. But other than that, it rinses completely clear off of the plastic. And note, frequently I've seen anyone with a fountain pen rollerball, some of the Italian makes come to mind, and handful of the Japanese, where that unit's actually quite expensive. There's one of them that it's actually worth more than this entire pen is brand new. These retips replacements are sold at luxury brands and through most Noodler's retailers. You can find them online, and you just pull that out with tweezers or with a pair of pliers, and you push a new one in, and you've replaced it. They last a long time on the writing machine. One of the reasons for using one of these out in the woods I've tended to is I lose them occasionally. You do hunting, you lose your pen. And I would like to think that somebody who's not familiar with fountain pens, they might, in the younger generation anyway, be familiar with a rollerball and figure it out and look up the name on the pen and maybe figure everything out. And they found a pen in the woods and maybe they might enjoy the hobby. And it didn't get lost for nothing. Now this is admittedly now dirty water. Maybe I should demonstrate it with clear water again, but you don't need a pen rinse. These are utilitarian tools to be used. They're not, it shouldn't be expensive. If you feel a fountain pen is expensive, costly, the cost is prohibitive, then it's not the same hobby I'm in. I don't consider it. I can show you the math where these things beat your average pen at the convenience counter, the uniballs and the like. I've done some videos that show the economics of the fountain pen. The economics is better. And the durability of this ink. And with the brush pens, I tend to fill it twice to drive the ink through the fibers. So that it, so that it writes right away. I tend to use the brush pen for carpentry, writing on wood, saving pallets, which sometimes are $30 now. If you can salvage a pallet, you actually save people who buy this some money. Every bit helps to keep this affordable. If there's ever price increases, note it's mainly because of transportation, the glass, plastic, chipboard, the box it comes in, all of those things have gone up, but what is controlled in Massachusetts, it is still a very, very frugal, tight ship operation. And I want you to have the best product for the money. Easily rinses out the plastic, yet it stays on the paper so that if you do have great-grandchildren, they can see the movement of your hand on that page. And this is, you can do this with sunlight. You can watch a lot of the other inks will fade with sunlight. And industrial bleach, it will rip this paper to shreds. And it's definitely not good for your hands. But you see, the noodler's black on all of these is perfectly okay. It's tough stuff, but it rinses out of your plastic pen with ease. And remember the video. It might be taken down by YouTube because they seem to hate certain amendments to the Bill of Rights. But this was fired out of a shotgun and driven out over with an automobile. And I believe it was entitled Biodegradable Plastics Are Durable. And it's a demonstration of how tough these pens are. And here's hoping for better times in the future.